Australian rules football? In the US? That's right. The United States Australian Football League is in a city near you. Go to usafl.com, find your team, check them out. We're a group full of men and women just like you. Join us for the fun athletic competition. Stay for the camaraderie.
We want the champions!
Log on and sign up to join your team at usafl.com.
All right, back for the second half. Austin and Columbus. Austin up 29-1. So a solid lead at this point in time. Dennis Ryan throws the ball up. Clue wins the ruck tap out. Nix gets the ball off the back flank to the half forward line, but turned around by Simon Ledston, and he's got plenty of time. Pops the ball up, it's touched. Trent Kirk gets the ball over. Out wide to runners. Ben May, the silky, straight down the throat of Nolan Cox. And that was a more typical style of ball movement that we see from Austin. They just weren't allowed to move it in that last 5 minutes. Coxie kicks it up. Just floated that one through. Let the breeze do a bit of work for him. Great goal. Austin get the first one on the board, and Columbus really need to find a way to stem that flow, because this happened in the first half as well. So the likes of Simpson in the middle are going to have to get hands on it. Ben Carpenter gets it out to Money. Money Merritt. Ball down to the deep in the forward line, and a nice little handy mark there. Has he got it? It's all clear. Nico. Yeah, Nico. Is it Nick Lewis? No, it's, oh yeah, I think it was Nick Lewis. It was a solid kick. And I'll tell you what, with this breeze, I think it's picked up to a 4 or 5 goal breeze almost. It's, you can see the trees in the background, they're blowing to the right. And I tell you what, this could be a big score line if Columbus don't get their hands on it. Good tap out there from McClure though. Follows up. That was a high, probably a little aggressive on that. Goes wide, Carpenter. Yellow boots, won't miss him in the after party tonight. Put those on. Shelton couldn't take the mark. And it's over the line. And this is really a dead pocket. You don't want to get caught down here. So Austin probably ruined getting stuck down here, but they'll have to find a way out. Ball up. Good double-fisted punch there from Columbus. Ball finds its way back to the boundary. Throw it in, thanks. Beautiful throw in. Simpson gets it. He's got plenty of time. He runs, but he gets tackled late. Frenchie gets a kick up to the forward line. No mark, put it on. Nolan Cox trying to get one off the ground. Again, showing some agility. But through for behind. Carpenter up from kick in. Ben May's got time. Ball booted straight back in, but it's hit the plastic work. Throw behind. Ball comes in quickly from Columbus, and the big fella's marked it out on the halfback flank. Kicks it inboard, dangerous spot. Play on, there's no whistle there. So the ball's been kicked. Ball spills to Carlton, he gets a handball over the top. And this looks like a running goal from number 12, and that is Pettinari, who's actually had quite a bit of it already today. And looking very good out there. Yep, 7749 to believe it's three behind. Ball got lost there, probably been kicked into the state of Ohio with the strong breeze. Punch out by McClure, got the ball to Simpson. It got tackled, a lot of pressure there from Austin, and umpires found something in there. It's a kick to Austin. Pettinari caught one high, and I think he felt that one for sure. He's all right. He says, give me the ball. Oh no, he's gonna have a spell. I thought he was gonna say, give me the ball. I earned that kick, I want to take it. I'm sure Christian Merrick will be happy to take it for him. Long kick with a strong wind, kicked in, but to no one. Columbus marking, back pocket. Ball kicked out wide. Two on one here, but Austin managed to get it. Handball out to May from Christu, and the boys have put their arms in the air and said, what about that one? But no avail, you can't change the umpire's mind. Dennis Ryan is staunch. Ball out in the flank there, pretty much on the boundary line. Kick in there to the deeper into the Austin forward line, but rebounded out by Columbus, and almost got a little slicky handball away there. Little fella. But knocked over the line. Dustin Brazel pumps the ball in from the boundary line, doing his duties. Benny May picks it up. But that wind has caught it and sucked it into the dead pocket. And over the line on the full. You don't want to get caught on this side of the ground if you're attacking to this end. If you can help it. Throw in, McClure gets the ball out, Simpson takes possession and says, I'm going to have a look around and see what I've got, but quickly the pressure came and Austin have choked it really. And Nick's gets the ball, it's around the centre of the ground, slightly on the half forward side, and could probably penetrate very deeply in here with this kick. Ball's up, Cox couldn't get it, defended there by Columbus. Again McClure, 1-2. Takes a bounce, this guy's got some toe. Handball on to Rob Adams, he pumps the ball into the half forward line and they just need a mark here if they can get one. They've got handball on it, they got a hand on it, that's good, but geez, Austin have got numbers there. And just didn't turn out that way and it's moved back through the middle with Merritt moving the ball out to Nick Lewis. Pocket, looks like it's gonna get stuck there. Nope, cleared out by Columbus. Great work there. Kicks it up to the wing, but snuck over the line on the full and really gave away what could have been a a good thrust there for Columbus. Ball kicked in. Seymour gets it, picks it in the half forward line, and Ben May just floating inside the 50 arc and loves getting these ones. And with his skills, I'd expect him to pop this up and let the breeze suck it through the goal. Oh, broke too soon. Dragged it left. Wasn't one of his better kicks. One behind. Well, the shame sheet says Anthony Butt, but I know Seymour's head if I've ever seen it. And that is Seymour number 10 out there. They try and put a few tricks on the team sheet just to keep you on your toes, and I'm not buying it. Ball kicked in, but, you know, pretty much giving it away, going short inside the 50 arc, and a very easy mark there to Austin. I think it might even be Nick Lewis again. Low trajectory kick, but I reckon that might have snuck in. Yes, it did. Nick has got his boots on today. And Austin further their lead. Now sitting on 8.56 to 3 behinds. And just showing their dominance, really. Be good to see Columbus just get a few drives here and get some flow, because I think they've got a good side, so be good to see some of that in the last part of this second half. Clear up again, wins the tap, he's been winning it all day. Trent Kirk gets the ball, very solid over the ball, gets the ball out, but handball was a bit high and loopy. Rob Adams gets it out, and the ball's inside 50 for one of the few times for Columbus, but Ben Carpenter's back with the support of his back line and clears the ball out to Malaysia. Ryan Malaysia. Short kick just outside the required distance. Tim Christou gets the ball on the defensive side of the centre. Pretty poor kick, really, though. Didn't dispose of it where he would probably want it. Question there about whether that was legal disposal or not, but no, caught high before disposing, so the first free kick is paid by Dennis Ryan. Booted out in the outer side, Hamilton takes it, kicks the ball up a bit loosely, but the breeze is tough. Picked up on the flank there, booted forward, but Carpenter still couldn't take what was probably a gimme for him. Still at the ground level though, second effort solid and doesn't let the ball get taken out by, oh, that was great work by Nicks, but he's pumped it into a danger zone, but there's no one there for Columbus, and so Christou gets it and moves it forward. Trent Kirk, solid again, gets the ball but couldn't get a clean handball, and so Columbus pressure was great there. And now they've brought it inside their 50, and this could be a shot on goal. We have Nathan Thornbury, Thornbury's probably touch outside 50 into a breeze. So we'll see what he can do here. It does look like he can kick a footy, but this breeze has become pretty damn solid. He's looking to pass it off, and he has. Didn't get a hold of it, so snap around the corner by 59. Matthew. But it's turned over, and Austin cleared it out with a wing to Ben May. Oh, and Greggy takes a mark in the half forward line. Has to get away quickly because he was under pressure, but it was a good mark. But Columbus have the numbers back and clear it out. With Ramo taking it out wide. And then going further wide out towards the boundary. Oh, it's a bit of a scuffle. Do we want to go and have a quick look at that with the camera? No, it's been broken up. Dustin Brazel, the general, comes in and says, boys, none of that, we don't need any of that rubbish. Preserve yourselves for the next couple of games. So ball's out of bounds, meanwhile, on the wing. Columbus trying to get that move down that outer side, and a couple of times it looked like they could string a few together, but the forward line fell down. McClure gets the clear tap again. He's probably got over 20 hit-outs so far today. Austin get the ball on the back flank, and there's a question as to whether that was a throw or an illegal disposal, but it's a throw in instead. Ball thrown in quickly. Kluwer gets it out again. Good work there by Columbus around the back of the contest. Pumping it inside 50. Punched out by Austin there, and ball get over. They get over the ball quickly and really give Carpenter a chance out in the back flank. Gets the handball over. He's got a free play. Cops one, but umpire didn't see it. He's down, but ball keeps moving. Play on. Carpenter's down. We'll see if the match committee will have a look at that one on the weekend and see if there's an infringement there worthy of a tribunal hearing. Mark down there on the half forward there by Chris Du. Gets it going quickly. Centre half forward. Cox is back there. As is Lewis, but we've got Cox off the ground. And I think he snuck that one in. Also doubles as a soccer player, Alan Cox. And that was a ripper. Just made the best of the opportunity. And let's just go back and see how Ben Carpenter's doing. He's having a little bit of a test on the ground. I think he copped a knock. And you might think he's in another part of the world right now because he's too flush, but he's not going off the ground. So I think he's said to himself, I can handle this. I'll have another crack. So another goal there to Cox. He's probably got four. I haven't got a score sheet, but he's playing really well up forward there. Ball down. Next gets the ball from handball, but tried to do too much. Probably held onto it for too long. And Columbus got around him and free kick for holding the ball. On the outer side on the cricket pitch. Ball kicked out. Good mark there. Sensational by Thornbury. Gets the ball moving quickly out to Simpson. Simpson takes a mark, but you can just sense he wants to play on. And he does. Gets the ball even wider, but couldn't hit the target, and it dribbles over the boundary. And it's been tough for Columbus to get anything working into the forward line today, and Austin have just got the knack of getting their numbers back and choking you. Ball down. Another one out. Merritt gets a kick again. He's had a fair bit of the footy today, but just dribbles around the corner to advance at 10 yards up the field for Austin, and that's a throw-in in the half-back flank. A very flat throw-in, and McClure gets it again, but this is Merritt again, just sharking the ball. Dribbles a kick, wasn't fantastic, but advanced the ball 30 yards up, and it's now on the forward half for Austin on the boundary. And it's just that attack of the ball and their run in numbers that this is so hard to overcome when you play Austin. Even contest in the ruck there, the ball's down, but recycled out to Simpson this time. He gets a kick. But recycled again by this Austin defence. Pumped the ball into a danger zone in the middle, and that'll turn over. So Columbus will get the ball here with the run. Gets a handball out. That's a really good play. Get the kick in. They need someone on the end of it. But taken well in the back there by Dylan Edwards. Solid in defence for Austin. Seymour gets the ball, pumps it from his half-back flank along the wing. Ball punched from Columbus over the line. And we'll throw it in again. That looked pretty good coming through there, the middle there from Columbus. You know, it was a turnover that they took advantage of, some run. They just didn't have that extra final kick to penetrate the forward line enough. And Austin were able to turn it over. Ball's down. It's a bit of a scrimmage. And to knock it out. It is by Columbus, but Seymour is running again. It's important. Greggy's got the ball, gets it on his left, and gets a nice kick up to Nix. And he's looking for runners. He says, come at me. Cox goes up. Good spoil from Columbus's Robert Gardner. He's got a tough job on Cox today, but he's done well there. And a good kick finds Spedding in the middle of the ground. He's got the headgear on, so he's in the spot. Ball hooked around the corner out on the wing, and he's spilled it up there, and Connell just gets the ball, takes possession, gives it to Kirk. Kirk's looking solid. He has a great disposal, but Cox has found himself behind. Gets hold of the footy though. Somehow, he guy's got agility at ground level that you shouldn't have at that height. Ball out. That was a good tackle, I thought. And it was a throw, so good work there by Columbus to squash the attack there from Austin. And it's a good quick out, good kick out, and halfback flank just on the outer side of the centre square. And ball goes wider again. And a good mark out there in the wing. Can't see the number on this fella's back, but he's got a couple of kicks. A little kick in there. Finds, I believe, Edmonds. Gets the ball out wide, but Ben May's going to take this and gobble it. And he's had plenty of it today. Kicks the ball in the middle dangerously, but is effective. You could argue duck down into that. Montgomery, but umpire has actually picked it out, ducking into it. So I think that was a fair call. Ball kick forward into the breeze, falls short. Frenchie gets the ball, kicks it on the outside of centre, and there's a mark, but it's also the siren signifying the end of the game. And Austin have taken this one out with a pretty comprehensive 9-8, 62-0, 3-3 for Columbus by 59 points. And you fear that they are going to be hard to beat today with that performance. And we'll just see how the other game that's going on right now between Dallas and Denver shapes up to see who's going to be the toughest opponent for Austin today. But solid performance, made the most of the breeze in that second half, kicked well into it in the first half. So, you know, just playing the way they like to play. And I think, you know, all credit to them. They brought only a fairly small squad for them up, 20-odd guys, but there's some pretty good quality out there, so I'd expect them to, in the back of that game and how they're looking, to be very hard to beat. So Austin wins by 59 points, thanks to our sponsors, Indiana City Brewery, again for supporting the after party and this telecast, in fact. So thanks very much to them. Get out there and support them tonight at the after party and on the weekend. We'll see you a bit later on in the next game. Good win to Austin.